Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this wonderful evening. We are here gathered by music, and of course, with Mr. Zhou, founder of this festival. I'm very honored to be here and not to be amongst some greatest teacher in the world of Western music. And some of them are here. I'm very honored. And some of them are my teachers. When I was in school in Peabody, and together with Ms. CHEN in US. And then later I went to Juilliard just to see, you know, what's music life in New York like. I think, you know, sometimes a city is can make a difference. This is the music life and the huge environment that the Western all can offer us is tremendous. That's why I choose, by accident, I choose the topic of from Mozart. But then I find out that Isaac Stern actually came to China for the first time in 1979, so which is exactly 40 years of that visit. And that I think it's an ice-breaking visit trip of culture. You know, before that, not only that we were in cultural revolution, like Ms. CHEN said, but we were also musically mostly influenced by the Russian school, the old Russian school, you know, like the Osrava. But after Isaac Stern came, then we start to realize, oh, there is music in the West, not only from the 50s, from our older generation, our father's generation. They only admire the old Russians. But then, and then Stern really came, and he gave many classes, open lessons. And he taught us how to treat music, how to think of music, how to sing. I remember he asked the one girl to put down the violin and say, sing, you know, you need to sing. And I think whether it's to sing or to speak intimately, I think it is very important that we have this deep connection, close connection with the intent of the music idea, which the composer which indicate in the black sheet of the music. And my teacher, same teacher with Ms. CHEN Brosanowski in Peabody, always said that you should always approach a piece so fresh that you thought that you think that this ink is still wet, even it's Tchaikovsky violin concerto. So every time you need to think of something within the tradition, within the hundred millions of people, great masters already contribute to this period of music, to this masterpiece, but then still you have to walk between the rain and get a way that's not be wet, so that you still find a way. So there's one Nobel Prize winner said that we are not really creating so many things. We are just rethink, reinvent some of the things which is already there. This is, as a performer, it's our duty, just to make the sheet music alive and then to touch people every day. So that's what our teachers also do to bring out the music. So let's talk about the trip of Isaac Stern. There is a very little picture, but this one is interesting. This is Ms. CHEN Zhou, actually. of course, I don't say how long ago, but this picture was a prize winner picture. So it was in the newspaper everywhere at the time. And that time, we don't even have TV, we have black, very little TV, so everybody actually read newspaper. So this is really a significant photo. So this guy is the first violin of Shanghai Quartet. So he was a college student, way down, and then some of them. So, and there's a famous saying that Isaac Stern said, each window, each practice room, there is a genius. You know, I think he was being very generous saying that. But that time, you know, you have to pick people, millions of people to come to the so-called elementary school of music. So we were very lucky to be among these few who are selected. And from that day to now, I think it's a huge difference. This 40 years, many of my students, classmates are here. They are playing everywhere. Some of them are in the Singapore Symphony Orchestra. So they are here, and it's really a generation of musicians who deeply benefited from the first visit of this great violinist. And I think he is also a great person, because he has a sense of helping other people, not just playing the violin, including all this Carnegie Hall story about that. So among the people that he helped who are not Chinese are Hermann Zuckerman, Dore, many of others that he actually helped to bring to this world. So I think it was a very good opportunity for us. And some of them, of our classmates, are in some of the symphony orchestra. Some is already being soloists, and some are being, you know, a very important position in the music school and everything. So this is what happens. I think sometimes, you know, religion, politics, a little bit, we have different view. So it's really from Mao to Mozart, but more the Western culture, Western thinking of Western music making. And then I think this is what's noble about the culture exchange. Anyway, so then later I'm going to present you with a very nice sonata by Mozart. I think also one of the most charming sonata by Mozart, K454, B flat major. And I can hear a little bit of the opera that I was in the Metropolitan Opera for 10 years. And always with Mozart, each note has some word. You can always find collaboration with this word. So anyway, I'm going to present you with this violin sonata. Thank you.
Pianist is Naaman Wagner. We are very lucky.
Thank you. Thank you.
This is that time. You know, I go back just for a second.
Miss Chen Zhou is here.
He become a conductor. This is a pianist. So that's when we were little. Wang Jie, the cellist, and Mr. Jin Li, he's here. He's a fantastic violinist, who only the only student that Mini Min brought from China to play with him, to study in his school in England. Now he's living in Singapore, yes. It's a recording, but that's a picture that that was the tour that they used. So you can see something is in his eyes, you know, very serious about. This is a composer, Mr. Chen Gang, who wrote the Butterfly Concerto. It's a very beautiful concerto. And that time, that's the only home that Isaac Stern went. It was not allowed. So they cleared all the, you know, the whole street for him. And he actually went to his home to pay a visit to a private home. That's the only place that he actually went. And after he arrived, he said, oh, I need a nap. In this hotel air conditioning is not great. So he took a nap. And then he played this sunshine on the Tashkurgan, this piece that I'm going to about to play. It was on the piano. And they talked about this is when this composer was young. And you can see the film crew in his home, you know, from Mozart, that film which got a Oscar prize for best documentary.
So
This is a photo album that Mr. Chen Gang, when I went to him, and he gave me a little warm regard to this festival, and then he showed me the photo. But you cannot take out of the album.
This expression
is like when he listened to all the people. And the minute, you know, I'm everybody here, we played for him. This is 2 years later, 81, Mr. Chen Gang went for the first time to America, and he went to Stern's home, and he gave him a colleague of writings, so talking about something about you know, working very hard for everything and all that. So that was, this was in his home, and that's when the movie was showing, and that's when they got the Oscar. But I think, on the other hand, the movie also inspired some Western kids to be more interested in classical music. So it's really significant. This is the only picture that, this is a Chinese, possibly, in the Song Dynasty, which is 1,000 years ago. And that's the only picture that I'm going to bring here to talk about. Chinese also have great culture. And their prime time was during that time, the Song Tang Dynasty. Incredible art and things. But a little bit lacking in the last 500 years, you know, when the steam revolution came. So, because we were so proud of our culture, so kind of we closed our doors, and that's not very good. But this is a very simple part, but the thing is, that time, on the other hand, that Western time was a medieval time. So, and that, you know, so, but Chinese is capable of beauty, and they are in their blood. They search for beautiful things always. Yeah. So, anyway, the next piece that I'm going to hear, maybe, you know, something different. It's not a pure Chinese piece. I think this is, the melodies come from Tashkurgan, and it's called Sunshine of Tashkurgan, but it's really the sunshine in our heart. It's in our mind. We always have to have sunshine, even though that, you know, what's going on in the world and everything. So, and the melody, always a lot of augmented seconds. So I was talking with Naaman about this augmented second theme. You know, it's very mid-Asia, and even Arabic, even the Jewish music a lot of. And then the second part of this piece was a feverish dance, which is like a moto perpetuo, also similar to the music which we were talking about, some of the Jewish music, it's exactly the same. So that's why I choose this piece, because it's in the middle, and that's where where the two river culture, which is Buddha Mania, that area, which is the earliest culture that we could find in the west of India, you know, things there. In the museum, you don't really notice. You go to all the world in the museum, you see this little pearl, not pearl, but this little beads sweats, sometimes very long. They put all their energy into this, making a hole which is like in the center, not breaking it. The nations of energy to put into this. And that's where it comes from. And you go to find a room everywhere in the world. It's where the thread connects all the culture together. And so I choose a piece, kind of find, you know, in there. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this. Thank you. Questions and everything, please. I'm here. Thank you.